Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the beautiful Crystal Cathedral and the 15th annual grand finale concert of the Continental Singers and Orchestra. We're delighted you're here tonight. And would you please welcome, for the beginning of the concert, the founder and president of Continental Ministries, Cam Floria.
Thank you. evening. Right now, we'd like to continue with this medley of familiar choruses, and we know that they're familiar to you, and so we want you to sing along with us tonight and just praise the Lord. So we're going to continue with the song we just started, He is Alive. You've got the words down, and the melody is very easy to catch on with. We're going to teach you the sign language that goes with it, and it goes like this. With your hand up like this for He, I can't tell if you're all doing it now, but I'm just going to have to trust. With your hands up in the air, I guess, for He, put your hand in a fist like this with the little finger out and bring it out from the chin for Is. Don't hurt yourself. All right? And then make some goalposts. Bring them up from the waist for Alive. He is alive. Got it? Here we go.
Christ is King. I say go get all excited, go tell everybody that Jesus Christ is King. Jesus Christ is King, the King of Kings. Jesus Christ is still the King of
Oh, it's so exciting to be in this fantastic place. You know, I've been sitting over there, I'm hooked up, looking at the airplanes go by. You can see so many fantastic things. You know, this building, you've heard so much about it. I've got a German friend with me, and he'd seen it and heard about it on German television. It's really, in our modern day, a tribute to God's greatness that he allowed this beautiful place to be built in his honor. And I'm sure that Dr. Schuller would enjoy us saying that, because it is for God's honor that his name is proclaimed in this beautiful place. And I'm glad you've come tonight. There's a big echo in here. It's going to be difficult for you to hear the words. That's why I'm glad most of you have already seen a concert anyway, and you already know these songs, so you can just enjoy the emotion of it, put it that way. We've got something though for everybody, for moms and dads and grandpas and grandmas, and a little later on something for the little kids. And you know, today you got to have music for young people, so the next couple of songs are really geared for the youth. But before I tell you about what those songs are, I want to remind you what our theme for the summer has been. Our opening song is called You Just Can't Stop the Music. And the music in our lives is the Lord Jesus Christ living in us and living through us. And that can't be stopped. You can't stop that music. Jesus is who the music is. And that's our theme for the summer. You can't stop the music. The first couple of songs talk about direction for us as Christians. We want to do a song called I Choose to Follow You, and we follow the Lord Jesus Christ in the power of his resurrection, which is our second song. But before we have either one of those songs, we're going to have the orchestra play a number that's become very dear to Christian people all over the world. And one of the beautiful phrases from this film was, and all of us as Christians can relate, as we run the race of life with Jesus Christ as our leader, he said, when I run, I feel I run for his pleasure. Larry and the orchestra.
Lead me in your light, I choose to follow you. And not to give up the fight, I take now my stand. As I cling to your hand, Father, you are enough for me.
I choose to follow you, no matter where you lead. I choose to follow you, for your grace is all I need. In my weakness you prove that your strength.
My choice.
so many roads to choose today. Everyone shouting, come this is the way. Maybe you're getting just a little bit confused. Listen to your heart and reason out the good news. There's only one who has an empty grave. Only one who rose on the third day. Only one with resurrection power. Jesus Christ is still the man of the hour.
He can turn your life around.
The time he quickened my body, spirit, soul, and mind. Born again, I felt so clean and brand new. In a moment's time, I was changed through and through.
But I know I've only had a little taste of what I'm gonna be on that great and final day. When the last trumpet of the Lord shall sound. Jesus is his name.
brings the sun in the morning and the moon at night.
And the raindrops, they glisten with their clear little light.
He put the colors in the rainbow, what a beautiful time!
He is the giver of life. Jesus is the giver and he gives me good things. Jesus is the giver and he gives me good things. You know what he is, you know what all the things that he brings. Jesus is the giver of life.
He puts the song in the birdie and the buzz in the bee.
He puts the flowers in the garden and the fish in the sea.
He puts the stars.
That was my little girl who sang the solo. I mean, hey, she did all right, didn't she? I hear you. Oh, well, we've got 16 different continental tours up here, and I want you to meet all the directors. We'll do 8 of them now and 8 of them later. And the first one I want to introduce to you is, you've been watching him conduct the orchestra. It's our tour B. That went to Bermuda in the Bahamas, and the orchestra tour traveled around the country, and I want you to meet their director, Mr. Larry Sparks. Larry?
We've had just about the most terrific summer that I think I've ever experienced in my whole life, and I think all these young people would agree with me. We had such a unique opportunity this year. We were the entertainment on a 3-day cruise ship to the Bahamas. We got to, I tell you, they got more than what they expected they were going to get, believe me. All our program was 45 minutes on the opening night, and they got exactly what you're getting tonight. It gave us a tremendous opportunity during the next day or two to have some time just to talk with people. Lots of folks wanted to come up and talk to us, and if they didn't want to talk to us, we certainly made way to talk to them a little bit. And had a wonderful time and a great response on the ship. And then we spent a week in Bermuda, which is probably the most beautiful island in the whole world, and had a really terrific ministry there. We did a concert every night, saw a lot of people come to know the Lord for the first time, come to understand who he really is. We had some time that we spent individually in different churches, ministering on our own and giving our testimonies, a lot of people singing solos and playing their instruments in different churches. But most of our tour this summer was spent traveling around the outer United States. I think some of the highlights this summer were, I think being the in-house orchestra at the Christian Artist Music Seminar was probably a real highlight for most of us, standing in front of a lot of really terrific ministers through contemporary Christian music that you've heard all about all your life, and all of a sudden you get to see them, and then they say, "Would you play this stuff for me?" And you sit there and, oh my goodness. We were so blessed that whole week. And then sailed on home all the way up through Salt Lake City to Seattle and straight down the coast. First Baptist Dallas was a real thrill for us this year as we saw a tremendous thing happen there one Sunday night. It's been a really neat summer for us. I think every one of us have grown not only to love each other with the love of the Lord, but to really understand the depth of his love. And we're glad now to be back home and get started and take that love back to the churches that we came from. Amen.
Okay, so I want you to meet our tour E, which stood for Europe, Europe's military bases. They traveled all around Europe and sang for our servicemen over there. Mr. Bob Feller was their director. Bob, tour E.
Thank you, Kim. We had the chance to go from Los Angeles to New York. It took about 2 weeks. And then we flew to Holland, where we spent about 2 or 3 days doing concerts there. And then we had the privilege of going south into West Germany and ministering to the American families on the military bases there. We spent about 10 days in West Germany. 8 of those concerts were to the American families on those bases. 2 of those concerts were German concerts for German audiences. One morning we had the privilege of going down into a local marketplace, just setting up our equipment and being able to minister to the Germans there. Many, many of them could not understand a word that we were singing, but they could see a difference on our faces. Many, many people interested in knowing about the Lord Jesus Christ. So in between 2 concerts, we had the opportunity to take tracts, German tracts, and pass them out to many, many of those people at that German concert. We went back into Holland and joined forces with tours G, H, and N for a combined finale concert in Rotterdam, Holland, that was recorded for a later broadcast to go throughout all of the Holland area. And it was very, very exciting for us to have a part in that. And we took 5 weeks to go from there on back to California, and we're back home now. We're glad to be here and glad to know that the Lord has used every one of us in a great and mighty way to spread the music of Jesus Christ this summer.
Bob Feller, Tour E. On this side over here, we have Tour G, Great Britain, our tour that went all over Great Britain, directed by John Frank. John?
Thank you, Cam. We had an exciting time this summer, just one of the most enjoyable summers I have ever spent with Continentals, as we traveled, just like Bob, in 2 weeks from California to New York, and then we flew to London, traveled around England for 10 days doing concerts there, and really were excited by the ministry there and the many possibilities as we stayed in people's homes and got to know them and know that there is 3% of the population are church-going people. And just knowing that there's such a need for the ministry there and knowing that the British Continentals were getting started there, and just to be able to go throughout the country with the message that we had this summer, that Jesus is the music that just can't be stopped in our lives. We then went over to Holland and to West Germany with an exciting time there, staying in the people's homes. That's where so much of the ministry is, and trying to figure out how to communicate that you want a glass of water to someone that you can't understand a word that they're saying and they can't understand a word that you're saying. It's just one of the unique parts of the Continental Ministry in the summer. We then joined Tours E and N and H for that Rotterdam finale, an exciting time there, and flew back to New York and have been traveling across the United States again, up through Wisconsin and to Washington and back down to be here with you tonight. And it has reaffirmed my belief in Continental Ministries this summer that God uses Continentals to change lives, not only in the many people that we sing to and that come forward and receive Christ and rededicate their lives, but in my life and in all the Continentals on this tour, as we have all witnessed God working in each one of us and the love that he has given for each other as we've gotten to know each other. And I thank him for that, and I thank you for being here tonight.
John Frank, Tour G. And on this side, I've got Tour H. Tour H went from, of course, around the U.S. like they all do, but from Holland to Helsinki, Finland, and all throughout Scandinavia. Their director was Scott Naumann. Scott?
We had the privilege of traveling all across the United States, flying out of New York and ministering in the countries of Finland, then over to Sweden, down into Norway, and then into Germany and over to Holland. We had a very special ministry over in the country of Norway. Continental Singers had not been in the country of Norway since 1972, and my instructions from our Thousand Oaks office before we left was just to give as many outdoor concerts and try to obtain as many contacts as possible for future concerts for our 1983 season. Well, after we arrived in Norway, we had taken a hotel in the city of Oslo, and we had learned of the National Baptist Convention that was being held about 5 hours south-southwest of Oslo. And we headed out the next morning, hoping that we would be able to obtain some sponsors, make some contacts for next summer. Well, all this time I had been trying to call down there to at least see if we could possibly do anything for that particular national convention, and was unable to get a hold of anyone. So we stepped out on faith that next morning. We did a Bible study on the bus in dealing with faith. First of all, they didn't know that we were coming. And secondly, we didn't even know if they needed us. And we went beyond that step of faith, and the second gentleman that we met was very, very moved, and he said, Scott, you don't know what it means to us to have you here with us. He said, at our convention, each year we have a musical praise service, and that's scheduled for tomorrow night. And it's very, very strange that you're here because, well, our music group that was scheduled to be here for tomorrow evening canceled 2 days ago. And we were able to stay in the hotel and have our meals covered while we were in the city there. And just to allow the Lord to really be glorified and to show us that he was being glorified in that whole situation, at the close of our concert, there were about 1,500 people at that concert the next evening. And there were between 60 and 75 people that came forward and placed their trust in Jesus Christ that night. We were thankful for that. And then, just to let you know who this guy was that met me the day beforehand, this gentleman is in charge of all of the Baptist youth in the entire country of Norway. So we have our sponsors, and we really feel that the Lord was glorified. If Tour H stands for anything, we really feel it stands for harvest. The Lord has richly allowed us to witness a harvest of people that have come to know Jesus in a personal way this summer, and we're thankful for that.
Scott, Tour Harvest. Now, over on this side, we have a group with different outfits. That's because they're our UK group. They're the Continentals who came all the way from Great Britain. They're our British Continentals making their first trip to America. And I'm glad you clapped, but I've got to tell you who the director is. That's Paul Nelson over there, Biola graduate, or working on his degree at Biola. Anyway, Paul, want to tell us about the UK tour?
Well, thank you very much for your warm reception. Tour UK is a tour of fulfilled dreams and discoveries. Fulfilled dreams in that in 1978, the first British Continental Tour went out on the road, and a fulfilled dream that tonight, after 5 years of existing, we're able to complete the Continental family here on this stage tonight. We can't tell you what a thrill it is and what a privilege it is to share with you this evening together. It has been a tour of discoveries as we've gone into God's Word and we found out who we are as born ones of God. We've also found out that we have a purpose and a meaning for living. And by God's grace, we're going to send these kids home tomorrow standing on the solid rock of God's Word and their relationship with Jesus Christ. We've been together for a month. We started in the 1st of August. We had a week-long rehearsal in a little farming town in East England. Then we spent a week touring England, and we have been here just about a little over a week touring Southern California and then up north and back down. Tonight is the climax of this tour, and we just praise the Lord that we are able to share this evening with you.
Paul Nelson, UK. Now, behind me, getting ready, is our tour M. M for Mediterranean countries. They were in Spain and Greece and France. Now, whether you know this or not, all of the directors for the Continentals have been themselves a Continental. So some of them have been with us for years and years and years. And from time to time, they move on to a church ministry or some other ministry where the Lord leads them. And I'm sorry to say, this is the last summer for this director, Mr. Brent Edwards. But he's going to say hello to you. Brent Edwards and Tour M.
Thank you. Thank you, Cam. Tour M this year was a tremendous experience for each one of us. I think the Lord taught us how to grow as a family and share that joy of the family wherever we went. We walked through a place called the Ancient Agora in Athens, which was right beneath the Acropolis. And as we walked around looking at temples of different gods and groups of gods, we were reminded as we looked up to Mars Hill, where in Acts it tells us of Paul's speech, where he said, "Men of Athens, I see you are religious people." Of St. Peter's speech. We were reminded all the time in our concerts there that the people were religious, so to speak, but 99% of them were from the Greek Orthodox Church, either by choice or otherwise. And that left 1% for everyone else, not just 1% Christians. And at a time of sharing in a concert in a huge city square in Athens where thousands of people gathered most of the time just to sit at outdoor bars and pastry shops, the word joy that you'll hear in just a few moments became real to us. We had a time to fellowship at a meal right beneath the Acropolis, our last night there. And to sum it all up, a man who had been our hotel host came to our sponsor in Greece later on and said, "Your young people tonight showed me a lot because we had the wine, but you had the joy." And that's what it's all about. We have shared joy, and we thank you for sharing in that joy with us tonight. Brent Edwards, Tour M. Just down the way a little bit is Tour N. Tour N spent their summer, a part of it, in Northern Europe, in the Scandinavian countries, and I'll let their director, Scott Lee, tell you about that. Scott?
We left Los Angeles and took a month to travel through the southern part of the United States, then flew overseas, and we landed in Holland, and our second day into Holland, that's when we had the opportunity to be part of the Holland finale, along with the other three tours. Then our tour took us to East and West Germany, Denmark and Sweden, and after about 3 weeks, we've been touring across the northern part of the United States, and here we are back in Los Angeles. Glad to be here again. I guess one of the highlights of our tour was a surprise in the fact that we got to go into East Germany. We got into the bus one day, and we asked the road manager, "Where do we go today?" And he said, "Well, are you ready for this? We're going to West Berlin." And so we went through on the transit road, going through the communist part of East Germany. As we'd go through the little towns, we'd see the propaganda signs of the three leaders of the Communist Party. We came into one, and there was this huge sign of a giant fist with a crumpled American airplane in the fist. And all of a sudden, it drove home to us that the Americans stand, especially a group like this, stand for Jesus Christ as they go overseas. But all of a sudden, we were in an area where people didn't care if we were Americans, they didn't care if we were Christians, and certainly didn't want to have anything to do with us. But once we got into West Berlin, we had one of the most exciting concerts that we had the whole summer as we saw a warm church body and people changed, especially in that concert, as we have throughout the summer. Tonight is a fitting climax for an incredible summer that saw people's lives changed, our lives changed, and we just give God the glory for the things that happened this summer. Thank you.
Great.
Scott Lee, our own little Billy Graham. And just the other side of Tour N is Tour U. That's a United States tour. They went all around the U.S. and out into eastern Canada. They're directed by the very first lady continental director ever, Julia Winterberg. Just, let's clap for Julia. It's all right. It's no problem.
Well, there's no place like home, and we had a marvelous time as we stayed home this summer and explored the beauty and the people of the United States of America. And we started travel through the southern states, over to the east coast, went up, spent some time in New England, and we visited our neighbor country, Canada, and had 9 beautiful days as we played to packed houses there. And we continued our trip back into the United States, the Midwestern part, sharing in a prison there and several nursing homes, having beautiful experiences we've shared this summer on the road. And for me, as a director, it's been beautiful to be part of this group and to see the growth that has gone on in this group this summer in our lives and having opportunity to share with so many people at the concerts and in the homes afterwards, seeing that a need is there worldwide and that we have found the answer in Jesus Christ. And it's been a pleasure for us to share this summer as we've traveled.
Julia, tour you.
Well, throughout the first part of the program so far, we've been talking to you about the who of our music, Jesus Christ. If I had to decide what the what would be, I would say the what of our music is the gospel. That's what we're singing about, is the gospel of Jesus Christ. And where are we singing it? In every country of the world. In fact, everywhere we go is continental country. And that brought to our minds, wow, the continental country, maybe we should put some country music in the continental country program. So the next little bit is some country music, and we're going to start it off with the Tour H Band. They're going to play a medley of old country gospel spirituals called Swing Down Chariot Medley, Tour H.
Sound is dead, so they say. You've got to have soul, or at least a rock and roll in the songs that we're singing today.
Well, that may be true for some people, crazy people, but for me, you just can't go wrong.
You can't go wrong.
You see.
Thank you.
Thank you. $2 will make it $3 twice, now that's a good price. But who's got a beer for me? Raise up your hand and don't wait any longer. The auction's about to end.
People stood around, and the sun was setting low. And then from the back of the crowd, a gray-haired man, he came forward and he picked up the ball. He wiped off all the dust from the old violin, and then he tightened up the strings. And he played out a melody pure and sweet, as sweet as the angels sing. Then the music stopped, and the auctioneer, in a voice that was quiet and low, he said, "What is my bid on this old violin?" As he held it up with a bow, and then he cried out, "One, give me 1,000, who'll make it two? Only 2,000, who'll make it three? 3,000 twice, now that's a good price. But who's got a beer for me?" The people called out, "What made the change? We don't understand." Then the auctioneer stopped, and he said with a smile, "It was a touch of the master's hand."
It was a touch of the master's hand. Now you know many a man with a life out of tune is battered and scarred with sin, and he's auctioning you cheap to a thankless world.
Yeah.
and fear of death just seemed to hang across the sky. And the pain just kept on burning, though the tears had all been cried.
We were talking as we journeyed toward a quiet country town, when another traveler asked us why we seemed so sad and down. It was like a dam that burst inside as I spoke my grief and woe, amazed that someone leaving there could somehow still not know. But the traveler called us foolish men and dull and slow of heart. And then he showed us from the scriptures God had planned it from the start. But it wasn't till the evening that our eyes were open there, and we knew that it was Jesus, but he vanished in the air. We rushed back to Jerusalem to tell the others there. They said, Peter, see him too. There was excitement everywhere, nearly shouting to each other as the realization grew, when all at once he spoke to us. Peace be unto you. And then he smiled a smile of love that left no cause for doubt. And then because he knew our hearts, he spoke our feelings out.
He spoke our feelings out.
Why are you so troubled? Why are you in fear?
See my hands and see my feet. I myself am here. Reach out now and handle me until you've all been shown. My life is more than spirit, for I'm here in flesh and bone.
Some lifted hands toward heaven and then knelt without a sound. And some just stood and stared at him as if rooted to the ground. But I could not contain the joy that flooded heart and soul. Came rushing out in praises. I had no wish to control a joy, 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 oh, joy, joy, joy.
Jesus.
I think that all of the Continentals would want me to say that we appreciate your applause, but with all of our hearts and all of our spirits, the glory for that fantastic song and all the music goes to God, the creator of music in our lives, and to Jesus Christ, his son, who changes everything in our lives. Well, it's been a fantastic summer, and this is the night before the end. Tomorrow night, they will all be giving their final performances. And it's been thrilling for me today to sit here and listen to them sing and rehearse and hear the stories about how God has done wonderful things all summer. I think that the thing that I'm most grateful for is when you have 16 groups that are flying thousands of miles, and each bus will drive somewhere between 10 and 15,000 miles. That's a lot of miles, and God took care of us all summer with no accidents and no problems, and we really are grateful for that.
Hello. Are you having a good time tonight? Well, you know, we've been working so hard up here, and they've been singing their hearts out. We thought we'd have a chance for you to sing tonight just a little bit with us. Are you for that? Is that okay? All right. It's a very simple song. It's a song that talks about the way the world will know. As we travel around as Continental singers, you've heard it said many times tonight that even though we didn't speak the language, they were able to tell something was different. And this song says why. The words go like this. They will know us by our love. They will know us by our love. Just one way that he says, they'll know we are his, they'll know us by our love. Listen to the melody and sing along just as soon as you pick it up. Enjoy with us as we sing about his love and what we share together as Christians.
They will know us by our love. They will know us by one way that he says, they'll know we are his. They will know us by our love.
See if you can try it with us this time.
They will know us by our love. They will know us by our love.
Just one way that he says,
just one way.
Tell the world the change he's made inside, but the cold and empty still proves they don't see. Beyond our words, they're looking for a difference in our lives. It's the love that he gave between you and me. Let's hear you sing it. They'll know us by our love.
They will know us by our love. Just one way that he says, they'll know we are his. They will know us by our love. They will know us by our love.
The love of Jesus.
Oh,
the sweet love of Jesus. One way that he says, they'll know we are his. They will know us by our love. Last line again.
They will know. Love.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Well, that's a great way to begin the second half, Sing to God with Gladness. A great anthem by Floor Peters, in case you've ever sung any of his music. I want to take a minute now to introduce you to the rest of the directors this summer. Up here in this area, right over here, is our Tour A. Tour A went to Africa, among other places. Their director is Madi Kelso. Madi?
Tour A, from the very beginning, stood for adventure. And throughout the summer, we've experienced a lot of adventure and variety in our ministry. But I think back over the summer, and I think what capsulizes it most is God's blessings on us, as He's answered prayer daily for us. I think one of the greatest prayers He answered was at the very beginning, before we went out overseas to Africa. We had been guaranteed that we would have our visas to go into South Africa by the time we left. It got down to that day that we were to leave, and we still had not received our visas to go to Africa. Needless to say, we went to our knees and prayed, and that very day, we did receive our visas from South Africa. We received our passports with the stamp visa 1 hour before takeoff, before we were supposed to leave. Well, that was just the beginning of an incredible tour in Africa. You know, we go there with preconceived ideas, and all those ideas are dashed as we realize that as Youth for Christ had planned an incredible concert tour for us in South Africa. Needless to say, though, that the day we landed there, again, God answered prayer. And the government, who owns all the media, multimedia networks, had arranged for us to do a television taping in Zimbabwe. And that day, the day we landed, we did a television taping of our concert, and it was taped or run all over Zimbabwe. Quite ironic for a socialist government, I'd say. And then from Africa, we had the privilege of going on to Rome for 3 days. They're sponsored by a group called the Centurions, doing concerts in parks and open places. God answered one of our greatest prayers, and that people might come to know the Lord through us, that we would carry that song that we've been talking about to the lives of those people, that they would see the joy in us. And God did answer our prayers for Tour A.
Madi Kelso, Tour A. Now, right behind me is a group we call Tour C. They went from California to Colorado. They stopped off in Hawaii. I don't know how that works, but that's what they did. Tour C and Wayne Graham.
We have a special greeting for you right now. Aloha! We had some time in Hawaii that we really enjoyed. We covered the western half of the United States, all the way east to Iowa and to Texas. The Lord used us while we were in Hawaii. We didn't go to get from the island of Oahu, but we went to give, and we gave of our time and of our lives. We had planned concerts on the beaches, in malls and shopping centers, in churches there on the island, and also we were with the Oahu State Prison System. While we were there in the prison system, we saw people that had their freedom taken away, but yet some of the people in that prison had more freedom than most of the people that we know in the outside world. There was a body of Christians that we went and encouraged, and also there were some unbelievers there that we challenged with the word of the gospel. I think of people that our lives touched, like Mario from San Francisco. We were on the beach at Waikiki, right beside the Rainbow Hilton. There we did a morning concert in our shorts and t-shirts. They were in their bathing suits. And we sang about the songs that are so important to us and the words of Jesus Christ. And his life was touched. He was a businessman from San Francisco, and yet he gave all that up and decided the Lord wanted him to stay there in Honolulu to work with the Waikiki Beach Chaplaincy. And he's going to do that for as long as the Lord tells him. We know that the Lord has used our tour and all of these tours as we've traveled this summer. And it's great to share with you tonight what he's done in our lives. Thank you.
Tour C, Wayne Graham. Next tour has been someplace I've never been, always wanted to go, someday will. Tour I, Israel, Italy, and lots of other places, and their director is Jim Chafee. Jim?
Thank you, Cam. We've had an exciting summer.
not only to go to Israel, but also to be the first Continental Singers group to ever go to Egypt, a country which is 90% Muslim. Our time in Israel was very special for us, not just because we got to see those areas where Jesus walked, but we got to do very significant things, like Brent was saying about Tour M. We went up on a hillside, the Hill of the Beatitudes, one afternoon and sat and read through the Beatitudes together and the whole Sermon on the Mount. And it's one of those experiences that we will never forget, because we have a point of identity with that passage of Scripture now, and we know what it was like, and we get the feeling, and it was just a marvelous experience for us. In Egypt, we had the opportunity of sharing in three different concerts. As I said, the country is 90% Muslim, and even though you can worship in the church of your choice in Egypt, it is against the law to go out on the street and openly witness to a Muslim person. They'll arrest you for it. But we had the chance, because they advertise the concerts, to see people come into the churches. One church in Cairo in particular was a large Presbyterian church. There were about 2,000 people there that night, and see a number of people accept Jesus Christ for the first time. Muslim people, other people that are from the country there. It's been a marvelous summer for us and a great experience that we'll never forget.
Tour I, Jim Chaffee. I didn't tell you this, but this is Mr. Chaffee's last continental tour. He's going to do something else special I'll tell you about later, but he came on a tour in 1969. He's been with us a long time, and we appreciate having Jim with us. And the next director, our director of Tour O, Brian Mulder, he's also moving on to a full-time church music position and spent, I think, 6 years, right, with us, 6 years. And Brian is moving on and making room for some of the young assistant directors who are coming up through the Continental program. This is Tour O. They've been to the Orient, directed by Brian Mulder.
Thank you, Cam.
Hello.
Thank you, Cam. The Orient, Singapore, Indonesia, the Philippines, and Hong Kong, was a very strenuous tour. But I think more important than that, it was a very rewarding tour. And of all the places that I've been in my 6 years with the Continentals, Indonesia is the place that really has ministered to me the most. I'll give you a little example of that. We flew to Indonesia on my birthday, August 4th, and I'd like to explain to you some of the things that happened on that day that will make me never forget my birthday in 1982. First of all, we were in Singapore, and we got up at 4 o'clock in the morning to catch our plane to Indonesia. Then, after flying into Indonesia, I spent 2 hours with the customs people trying to get our equipment into the country. After I was unsuccessful, our host stayed, and we left and went to the concert site. We drove for 5 hours through the mountains to the concert site that night, and as we drove, we saw poverty all around us. The most severe poverty I've ever seen in my life. I was beginning to wonder if this was really a place where Continentals belonged. It just seemed to me to be so different. I didn't know whether anything that we could do could reach these people. But on our way to the concert site, I began to think of all the things that God was teaching me just in those last few hours. We arrived at the place where we were staying, changed quickly into our clothes, and then a thunderstorm hit in the middle of dry season. And so we were a little wet. We went to the concert site. The thunderstorm had caused about 2 inches of mud to be all over the ground. And we walked into the place where the concert was supposed to be, and there were no lights. There were 1,000, at least, people inside that hall with 6 or 7 candles. And we arrived about an hour and a half after the concert was supposed to begin. And those people had been singing for an hour and a half in the dark. And right then, I realized that God had something special for the Continentals. So we got ready to do our concert with no equipment and none of our music, because that was all with the equipment, and no electricity. And about 30 seconds before we walked on, all the lights came on, and those people let out the biggest yell of excitement you've ever heard in your life. And when the lights went on, we saw that there was a full stage full of rhythm instruments, guitars, bass, piano, microphones, lights, and all those kinds of things. And so we walked up there and we did a concert, and it's got to be one of the most special times I've ever had as a Continental director, just to see God show me over and over again, this is exactly where I want you to be, and I have this to teach you if you will just listen and learn. And that's the kind of summer that it's been for Tour O. Thank you for all your support.
Brian, Tour O. On this side, we have Tour S, our tour, our Spanish tour that went to South America, directed by Johnny Johnson. Tour S.
We had such a wonderful privilege this summer to be able to minister throughout South America. In the past 3 years, Continentals have been able to be in 7 different South American countries. And this ministry is a special ministry in that it ministers directly in the language of Spanish. And the program that you're hearing this evening, we did 60% of the entire program in Spanish so that we could minister directly to those people who just didn't understand English very well, both in the United States in bilingual churches and in the countries of Peru, Bolivia, Brazil, and Colombia. We took the message of Jesus Christ in song. High up in the Andes Mountains or on the port cities of Trujillo and Chimbote and Lima and Cochabamba and Rio de Janeiro and in Bogota, we were able to go into auditoriums and churches to sing to old people and young people in schools, to bring the message of the life of Jesus Christ and the new life that he brings. We were privileged to sing to nearly 13,000 people during the time when we were in South America, and several hundred of those people came to know Jesus Christ. We worked in the capacity of evangelism, where working with another Christian organization, we would go in and present the program of music and message, which was interpreted, and many of the young people, being fluent in language, gave testimonies. And then after that, the message of the gospel was presented, and people responded by coming forward to receive him into their lives. We're so thankful for the opportunity we've had to be a part of this ministry, and are looking forward to the great opportunities that God has in store for the Spanish outreach in the future. Thank you, Cam.
You know, John, before you put your microphone away, I was just thinking that this is one tour that doesn't have an orchestra with them. They're doing tape tracks because it's in South America and it's a lot easier. They and the British Continentals used tapes, but I think it'd be fun if the people could hear you sing a little bit in Spanish. Why don't you get Julia's band to help you out and do a little bit of the medley in Spanish? Or did you want to do something else? Because I think that's okay, isn't it? Okay, do a little bit of that. Then I'll stop you in a minute. We're doing okay on time, John.
Vive Cristo very good tourist. And over on this side, we have Tour V. They told me in the beginning it stood for victory. It's the tour that went up the West Coast to Vancouver and other places, directed by Jim Schmidt. Jim?
Tour V has had a good summer. We had the opportunity to travel up the West Coast, spent some time in the three Western Canadian provinces, and we also spent 2 weeks in Alaska in the cities of Ketchikan, Sitka, Juneau, and Anchorage. While we were in Juneau, we had the last-minute opportunity to do an outdoor concert at lunchtime, kind of right in the middle of town, right next to the harbor. And there happened to be a couple large cruise ships in, and so there were quite a few tourists from the ships that were just kind of browsing around the town, and we had the opportunity to minister to them and to speak with some of them afterwards, and some even made decisions that day. In Sitka, on a particular Sunday morning, we had the opportunity to split up into small groups and spend time in the Sunday morning worship services at four different churches. And we found that as we were obedient to God in just little ways, He would turn that small obedience into big results. And we found another thing to be true. The Western U.S. and Western Canada is a very heavily churched area. But we found that no matter where you go, whether it's your own neighborhood or to the remotest parts of the earth, we found that people need to hear the message of Jesus Christ. And it's been our privilege as a tour, as a family, to be able to spread the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ through music. Cam.
Great. Tour V. Jim. Way up in the corner over there is Tour W. Tour W is directed by Wayne. That's not why we call it Tour W. They go out into the West Indies and the Caribbean Islands. Wayne Fancher is their director. Wayne.
Thank you. Well, where do you begin when you begin to tell about experiences that change lives? It's kind of difficult. But I guess it all starts right here in the LA area. And we started here and went across the states and flew out of Miami, Florida, and spent about 2.5 weeks in the West Indies. We spent that time on the islands of Barbados, Jamaica, and Puerto Rico. And it was wonderful, not only in the beauty, but also in the ministry, a fulfilling ministry, as we got to share with thousands of people and see hundreds of them come to know the Lord Jesus Christ in a real and a personal way. And then when we got back to the States, I began to think about other opportunities and other blessings that the Lord sent our way. And I remember an afternoon, a hot afternoon in Florida, where we got to minister in an open-air concert to a prison, to a young man between the ages of 14 and 24. And as there were about 100 young men sitting out there, we got to see about 20 to 25 of them come to know the Lord Jesus Christ in a close and a personal way. And what a blessing that was. Truly, this summer has been a wonderful time. And it's been a fruitful time, not only to see the harvest, but also in our lives, because we've grown a lot, I feel. And the Lord has shown us an awful lot. And one of the things that He's shown us is truly how wonderful He is. And in fact, He's only beginning to scratch the surface. Tour W stands for wonderful. And our Lord and Savior is just that. He is wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you, Wayne. Tour W. The last tour down there is Tour Z. They traveled from Zurich to Zagreb and Switzerland, Hungary, and Austria. Some fantastic places of ministry. And their director is Eric Hobbs, but Eric is not here. Eric is a law student, and Cornell demanded his presence. And so as a freshman, he had to be there 3 or 4 days ago, and Johnny Johnson, whose Tour S ended about a month ago, went out and finished off the tour for them. But one of their assistant directors, Pat Bennett, will explain a little bit about Tour Z. Pat.
Tour Z had a wonderful summer this year. We toured through the northern United States and flew from New York City to Europe. We spent 3 wonderful weeks in the countries of Switzerland, Austria, and the communist countries of Hungary and Yugoslavia. During our stay in Hungary and Yugoslavia, during 4 days of concerts, we saw almost 500 people raise their hands to accept the Lord for the first time. including our communist guide, communist government guide, who told us that night after she raised her hand that her life would never be the same again. We came back to the States after 3 weeks, and I think one thing that we learned as a tour together is to really appreciate the freedom that we have in this country to worship the Lord in the way that the Lord wants us to.
Thank you, Pat. Tour Z. You know, it is fantastic, isn't it? Whenever we go overseas, we're always glad to come home. My wife and I came home from Holland a couple of days ago, and it's a thrill to be home. This is a great country that God has given to us. And as I'm thinking about that, I think about the battle that the Lord waged on our behalf a few thousand years ago. And a few years ago, we arranged a medley of hymns that sort of tells a story about that. And if you can picture in your mind the armies of the Lord early morning on the hills of Israel, coming into the battle to meet the armies of Satan, and a great battle ensues. And of course, the victor is Jesus Christ, who is crowned Lord of all. And as this story goes, we will have Larry Sparks, our Continental Orchestra director, direct the orchestra in a medley we call the Banner Medley. Larry. That was great, Larry, and orchestra. That was exciting. That gave me a chill. We're almost finished with the program this year. It's been great to be here. You've been a wonderful audience. Tonight we've been talking about the music that can't be stopped, Jesus Christ and His gospel, and that we've been singing it everywhere around the world, the continental country. One other question or maybe two, to answer yet. The big question that comes to my mind right now is, why did God send Jesus Christ here? The obvious answer is for you and for me. We, all of us, we are the reason that he came. In spite of the fact that we failed in our lives, we reach out our hand, and he takes hold of our hand and leads us through. We are the reason.
As little children, we would dream of Christmas morn and all the gifts and toys we knew we'd find, but we never realized a baby born one blessed night gave us the greatest gift.
Here's the final number that tells the story of the whole summer. Great things have been accomplished, not because of who we are, but because of whose we are, because of whose I am.
Because of what I am. is flowing through my veins. I'm adopted by the King. It's because of whose I am.
I'll never understand. While I was yet a slave, He saved by me. Himself in flesh became the final sacrifice, so I could know redemption. He took the stripes upon His back so that I can walk in health. He broke the chains of death. Now I can live forevermore. It's not because of what because of what I am,
what I am.
Not because of
what I've done,
but because He first loved me.
His grace has set me free.
His blood is flowing through my veins.
My